हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आई एग्जाम बी. दिस इज ए सीरीज वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल इश्यूज क्वेश्चन फॉर नबार्ड ग्रेड एग्जाम. दीज आर द क्वेश्चंस यू हैव टू रिमेंबर एंड आल्सो अंडरस्टैंड द पैटर्न. दीज सिंपल क्वेश्चन कैन टेल यू व्हाट टू स्टडी एंड व्हाट टू स्किप ड्यूरिंग योर प्रिपरेशन. रिसेंटली द रैंकिंग ऑफ वेरियस कंट्रीज बेस्ड ऑन देयर जीडीपी एट पीपीपी परचेजिंग पावर पैरिटी फॉर रेफरेंस ईयर 2017 वॉज रिलीज. सी इन दिस क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो देयर इज दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन. सपोज इन द एग्जाम द क्वेश्चन कम्स that recently this ranking based on the PPP GDP is given, the base year is what? So you have to remember this, the base year for this calculation is 2017. Which countries, here the question is, which countries secured the first and the second position in terms of the PPP as largest economy in the world as per this report? A very interesting question, I am telling you, if you have not seen it minutely, you are going to do mistake. The correct answer to this one is, China is number one. And USA is number two. The difference is very minute. 16.4% contribution in the global economy by China and 16.3% by USA, because before this report, USA was number one. If you are reading an old book or a material which is not updated, you are going to do this mistake in the exam. Be very careful about it. And what was the India's ranking in this? You can guess it. If you don't, write in the comment. I will reply it there. Because for the exam purpose, India's ranking is very important. I have covered in several videos. Second question, which of the following indices in India are calculated using the same base year as GDP? So you know, we have discussed about the base year of GDP, the changes under discussion. Now the question here is, the base for GDP is 11-12. So which other indices is using the same base year? And as I said you in the exam, the question can be, what is the base year for India GDP calculation? So it is year 11-12 and IIP and WPI. IIP stands for Index of Industrial Production and WPI is your Wholesale Price Index. You have to know the base year for CPI, which is 2012. And also know things like where these indices are used. Like RBI uses CPI for the inflation targeting. Third question is, the Sustainable Development Report 2020 was recently released in July 20. Which country has secured the first position as per this report? Again, a very straightforward question. Sustainable Development Report, Sweden is the first country, which scores 84.72 among 166 countries. The top 5 countries are Sweden, Denmark, Finland, France and Germany. And the lowest one is Central African Republic, having a score of 38.45. These scores will not be asked, but the country rank you shall know, and also India's rank. And that is the second question. Fourth question means, the next question here, what is the India's rank as per the Sustainable Development Report 2020? Again, a very straightforward question. India's rank is 117. India's score was 61.92. And these ranking is done for achievement of the Sustainable Development Goals. You have to remember what are the Sustainable Development Goals. We have discussed it separately. In 2019, India's rank was 115. So India's rank has gone down. It does not mean that India has not progressed on the Sustainable Development Goals, but the progress by other countries have been better than the progress by India. So India's progress is not enough because we are losing in our ranking. Now next question is, fifth one, what is the current credit rating of the India as per Fitch ratings? Fitch, Moody's and S&P. These are the three important rating agencies. You shall know that. Now the question here is, which one is the rating as per the Fitch? All three you have to remember, only Moody's is different nomenclature. And for more such questions, for your practice, revision and learning, you can enroll in the course for NABARD Grade A. The free demo you can see at iexamb.com. Of course, there are video lessons, there are mock tests for phase 1, phase 2, including descriptive English, which is evaluated by our faculty and feedback is shared with you, including the discussions in live classes. As I said, Moody's only follows different nomenclature for S&P and Fitch. It is BBB negative. Moody's says Baa3. The outlook as per Fitch and Moody's is negative outlook. S&P say stable outlook. If I tell you in year 2020, Moody's has downgraded it, while S&P has retained the outlook, and Fitch downgraded the outlook from stable to negative. And these are important things. Please remember these for exam. The sixth question is, what is the name of the scheme announced by the government for the benefit of the street vendors? I think this is a very popular scheme. I have also discussed in many of my discussions, many of my questions. A very straightforward name, but if you have read it properly, otherwise it is difficult to guess. It is PM Street Vendors Atmanirbhar Nidhi. And under this scheme, a microcredit up to rupees 10,000 is given for street vendors. Those thela wala, those who give us sabji or maybe chaat wala, this is a working capital loan. The scheme is valid till March 2020 and implemented by SIDBI under Ministry of Housing and Urban Development Affairs. I am telling you, this ministry is going to be very confusing in the exam. Most of you are going to write finance ministry, because most of the finance related schemes are coming from there. Please remember this very, very well. In one question, there are many questions which can be formulated. So when I tell you, go through the answer explanations, whether you are doing our mock test or practice test, I am telling you, this is very, very important, reading every line carefully. The seventh question is, the MSME ministry launched a technology driven control room cum MIS portal to make smaller units big by solving their grievance and encouraging, supporting and holding them. What is the name of this portal? So this portal is supporting small units. You have to name the portal, which is called Champions. And this is by MSME ministry. It is written here in the question. But next time, as I said, the question may be Champions portal for this and this purpose is launched by which ministry? And Champions stand for, that makes another question. So Champions is creation and harmonious application of modern processes for increasing the output and national strength. This is the Champions portal, which is a kind of control room and MIS. Full form of MIS, you shall always remember, it is Management Information System. The eighth question is, again a straightforward question, who was appointed 37th National President of the Federation for Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry Ladies Organization? The correct answer to this is Jahanvi Phukan. She was appointed as President of FICCI Ladies Organization, FLO. FICCI, you know, it is an industry body. It has a ladies organization, so she is appointed as President of this. And before this, Harjinder Kaur Talwar was the President. She took oath in presence of Mr. Om Birla, Lok Sabha Speaker. She was founder member of the FLO North East Chapter in 2007. Ninth question, the government announced the restart of Hunar Haat or Crafts Fair for artisans and craftsperson from September 2020. What will be the name of the theme of the Hunar Haat? As the name suggests, Hunar Haat is a market for talent, and the theme for this is local to global. Hunar Haat provides market opportunity to master artisans and craftsmen from remote areas of the country for the rare and exquisite indigenous handmade product. Here again, remember Ministry of Minority Affairs. Right, here it is not MSME, it is Minority Affairs. Announced this scheme in May 2020. Hunar Haat has become an empowerment exchange for artisans and craftsmen from different parts of the country, and the theme is local to global. The last question is, who has taken charge as the new president of New Development Bank recently? Again, a very important question, I would say, for all competitive exam, but especially for NABARD, which is a development bank itself. You have these five options, and the correct answer is Marcos Rogio. He's from Brazil, and he has taken the presidency of this New Development Bank after the tenure of K.V. Kamath has been over. And Anil Kishora from India will be the new vice president. And in this kind of news, you shall also revise where is the headquarters of New Development Bank. Are you going to tell me in the comment below? That way you are going to be active participant in these discussions. If you have any more questions, any more query, you can reach to us at 920-55-24028. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon right now. Good luck for the preparation.